Hey everyone, it's Marcy, and it is sunny in both Smith River and Hilt today. So even though it's January, the sun out, it kind of got me looking at things on the shelves. I went by the gin section and I thought that I would take a moment to kind of walk you through the Bombay gin line because this is obviously a classic name. Lots of people know it, lots of people love it. And I figured I'd explain what the differences are and hopefully make you a little better educated on Bombay. So starting with the Bombay dry gin. In order to be called a gin, you have to have juniper somewhere in your botanicals that you use. Most gin obviously is using kind of like a grain neutral spirit at the base of it, kind of like a vodka. Some of them we have, like Bummer and Lazarus, is a gluten free vodka because they use a grape, a distillate at the base that's made from grapes. With Bombay, you're going to be using like a vodka base to it, and then they are going to be adding in the botanicals. With normal Bombay, you're actually getting eight botanicals, and they call it kind of their essential eight. Juniper berries, obviously one, coriander, angelica root, almonds, lemon peel, cassia bark, orris, and then licorice are the eight that make up the original Bombay. So their kind of featured cocktail for this is obviously a gin and tonic, and they do a really nice job. With this, it is that classic London dry gin, and probably one of the most iconic gins, other than I think Tanqueray. I think everybody knows the Tanqueray bottle, but the blue Bombay Sapphire is probably one of the most iconic gins, and for good reason. There are 10 botanicals that are used in this. There are essential eight that we talked about, and then they also add grains of paradise. And I may pronounce this wrong, but it's like cubid berries. The cubid berries is a black peppercorn. Kind of allspice flavored berry. And then the grains of paradise is in the cardamom family. And it's got kind of like this sweetness to it that actually sort of slowly builds to a smoky heat. With Bombay Sapphire, it is regarded as one of kind of the most versatile and best gins. A lot of people will say you can do a gin and tonic with it, you can do a dirty martini with it, you can make a great cocktail with it. It's got some versatility that I think some people would maybe say that the normal Bombay doesn't have. The other thing about their master distiller or their master of botanicals is that they've kind of gone to all parts of the world in order to find and source the botanicals that they use. They're very particular in where they got their botanicals from. He has cultivated relationships with those growers and those farms that they produce or that produce the botanicals for them. So they have sort of like these single sources for the botanicals that they're using. And I think probably, although the iconic blue bottle is noticeable, the blue label on this is actually their East version. And what the East version represented was it was sort of an homage to the fact that he's been to all four corners of the world searching for the best botanicals. He spent a lot of time in the Far East sourcing some of the botanicals. And so he wanted to do a gin that paid homage to the flavors of the East. So you have the 10 botanicals of Bombay Sapphire, and then you also have Thai lemongrass and Vietnamese black peppercorns that are added to this. And when they talk about a really great way to enjoy the Bombay Sapphire East, again, it's very simple. It's a gin and tonic. And one thing I would say when you're doing your gin and tonics, especially if you're stepping up to like the Sapphire or the Sapphire East, make sure that you're getting a really high quality tonic to go with that, especially one that uses maybe like a natural quinine instead of a synthetic one. You'll find that in the Q tonics or the Fever Tree tonics are a great way to go. The other thing is that sometimes, and maybe this is just me, but I am totally lazy if it comes to making myself a cocktail. So the fact that the way that they suggest drinking these are very simple and elegant really appeals to me because one, they're not trying to mask the flavors with a bunch of other stuff. And two, as I joke around with customers all the time in the store, that if it requires more than ice, I might like be out as far as making it. So the fact that it's like a glass ice, the Bombay Sapphire or the Bombay Sapphire East, and then some tonic water, that's easy. Anybody can do it. And if you're looking for something that's going to give you a slight twist and still impress your friends, I think that the Bombay Sapphire East is kind of a nice one to come or to try. Regular Bombay and Bombay Sapphire are available in 750 and 1.75 size in the store. The East is only available in 750s. We have a great price. You now know all about Bombay Sapphire or Bombay, the line. I hope you'll come in, try one of the three. Or can pick one of each of them up and compare them and let us know what you think. We'll see you next time at All Star Liquor.